Well, welcome to episode 3. We left off last episode, where I think I have pretty much investigated this whole village. I'm not sure if this is Fort Henry or not. It's the center of the map, so one would think that this is Fort Henry, but there was a letter found here, clue, talking about being unable to send men to Fort Henry. So I don't know. Here's a box I didn't see last time. I can't care. Come on, it's not. That ammo's not very big. Alright, so we decided that at the beginning of episode 3, we would ring this bell. Here we go. Whoa! Weirdness is happening. Dig. Dug up what appears to be a human eyeball, though it feels more like stone, strangely heavy and warm in my hand. Ugh. See things I couldn't see before. Interesting. This is still... still doesn't want to be dug up. Anything new appear over here? Ooh, some boxes I didn't see before. Empty. Empty. Alright, well that, I can see, oh here's something. Where that bell noise would drive you crazy. Dug up a petrified ear. It's heavy and warm. Ugh. But I could hear things I couldn't hear before. Uh-oh. Who is this? What is this? It's a dude. I can talk to him. Though your mouth words, no sound issues forth. Huh. That doesn't seem very handy. Oop, what's this? Dig. Ugh, petrified tongue. It is heavy and warm. Ah, now I can speak. Okay. Let's give it another shot here. Maybe Mr. whatever he is over here. There you go. Where is Martha? Who is Martha? His wife. Who are you? Captain William Eastgrove. When did you last see her? On a hillside, we were sitting together. I was holding her hand, talking about our son. She'll find her for you if I can. Oh, great. That's great of me to volunteer. Whoa! I think I just peed a little bit. Hate to interrupt, but who are you talking to? Speaking to a wraith named William... A wraith? Okay, William Eastgrove. But I see no one. He appeared in the dark when I rang the bell and vanished when daylight returned. You scared him away. Lady in red. In the dark? How can that be? The sun has not moved in the sky. Are you certain of what you saw? No, not really. I couldn't see him until I found the strange eyeball. That is an unsettling discovery. An odd thing to pick up. Oh, I get a choice. I didn't know what it was at first. I thought it might be useful. Personally, find the tongue more unsettling. I thought it might be useful. I don't think you would have occurred to me Although you seem to have been right. Alright, who are you? I can't remember. I'm sure that I lived here, for this place is familiar, but it's like a dream. I can't quite recall. Do you remember anything? My sister. I have been searching for her, but I can't remember her name either. Perhaps she is hiding from the Spaniards, I reply, for they seem more beasts than men. Spaniards? I have seen no one but you since I awoke in the forest days ago. This girl must be blind. I assure you that there are no Spaniards here, not anymore. Huh. They seem real enough to me. Like the darkness and the wraith? What did he want of you, anyway? He is searching for his wife. What business is it of yours? I would help you find her, but it is hard to track what one cannot see. You think I'm lying, don't you? And I must seek my sister. Please let me know if you see her. We are twins. Oh, ho, ho, ho. I wonder if she's the girl that shot the arrow. Or maybe she's just lying. Maybe it really is her. So she should be easy to recognize. Where shall I find you if I have news to report? Meet right here, of course. And she's worried about the wraith's wife. I wonder why. Very well. Listening will lead you to areas of interest if you find different locations in the normal world versus the other world. So be sure to listen in both. Alright, so I guess... Well, let's listen. I hear strange things, but don't know what they are. But I gather... Are you still here? I finally made peace. Do you think these ash figures were the people who lived here? Which ash figures? You've not seen. This girl is blind. Trying to scare me? Seems horribly unsettling, but I've seen no such thing. Come over here about 15 feet and you'll see a dude. He's right there. Right there. There he is. He's right here. Come here. Follow me. Come on. He's right here. Dude, he's right here. Ooh. I'm hearing things. The loudest here. Is it you? I'm hearing stuff, but I don't know what it is. All right, but I gather that there are two worlds here. So I'm going to have to run around here in the regular daylight. And then I'm going to have to run around with that bell ringing, I guess. So that's pretty freaky deaky. So let's look at this map here. There's a circle right here. Whoops. Keep missing this circle. Eh? Is this it? Okay, so that circle is his thing there. I guess these circles mark out things to find. So let us go and find. Alright, down this path there seems to be something. I hope I don't come across any ghoulies. I'm hearing something with my petrified ear. Aha! Money, 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 money. I guess I want 400 and something. I want to buy a musket. How much? 184. It's not enough. Let's see. That circle disappeared. Bad guy down there. Weird. Shrouded in corruption. That must be that bar there on the map. There's a circle here. Okay, what's this? Why has the Lord Governor ordered us to collect up valuables and shiny trinkets to hide in the woods away from our settlements? What purpose can such measures serve but to deject a populace already forlorn from hunger, sickness, and constant harassment by Spanish attacks? Whoa. I thought that was a dude. Is that a guy up there? There's the fort. Let's crouch. Let us crouch. So we can see. What is up this way? Where did that guy go? Whoa. He has a gun. Hey, how about that? A musket load and a fork. Great. And a musket. Ooh, it says it's broken, though. It's a broken musket. Okay, so I guess I can't use it. Alright, where are we on the map? Ooh, there's a circle right over here. I hear it. What is it? Examine. Unmarked grave. Can I dig it up? Alright, where are we? It's another circle straight ahead. Am I still crouching? No. Yes. Hear it. I see a chest down there. But I hear something very close to me. Among the stones you find the remains of a woman. Strands of long dark hair are still attached to the moldering skull. It's a bullet hole in her forehead. Golly. She must have been really tall. Look at that. Is that a femur? Is that what that is? Something. Dig. A valuable looking distinctive necklace of gold and topaz. Well, I suppose it might have belonged to her. If I find out who owned the necklace, I might be able to identify who she is. Uh-oh. I see a bunch of guys down there. And another totem up ahead. Let's leave those guys for later. I want a musket or something. I'm not going to take on four of those guys. With just a cracked bow. Let's hope there's about 400 coins in this trunk right here. A pistol! Alright. Let's make him number one. Longbow number two. 10 bullets. There's the totem over there. I hear somebody. I am still crouching. Well, oh, there he is down there. Whoa, this guy right there. Alright, what we're gonna do, we're gonna try to wipe him out with the bow. Because I fear that if I kill him with the pistol, the guy behind him is going to hear and come running. Come on, gust of wind. As if on cue. Bead. You know, that's exactly what I was hoping on finding on this guy. Not a musket. No, glass beads. Alright, well, this episode is getting to be about 18 minutes. So we're going to quit this episode and start up with us trying to kill yonder bad guy.